Hi guys, welcome to Backyard Garage. Today I'll be showing you guys how to install headlight tint like a fuckwit. Alright guys, now we've got to take off the light. I don't know what fuckwit in Toyota engineered this shit, but it takes way too fucking long, but I'll help you guys show it. Alright, first tool we need in this installation is a Coke. Without this, I don't know what's going to happen. Alright, so first thing we need guys is just an 8mm. What are these things? They just have the bolts on here, just pull them off, easy as shit.
These ones there. But first you gotta take off this little thing which is on the inside.
All you have to do is just put your fingernails in between here, twist it, and it pulls straight out like it's nothing.
Easy.
There you can see. Easiest crap.
Easy. These are the stupid plastic things that are fucking impossible to get off. Move your hand. These little things. They have like these clips and they're impossible to get off. I don't know, we might be dumb cunts, but who knows. Yeah.
Alright, so with these clips, we just want to get a screwdriver into here and just pry them off. Don't worry, you won't break them, you're going to be fine. Just pull it off and it'll pop off eventually and it'll all be good. After that, we just pull the headlight out, as simple as that. We take it over to our eBay tint, next to the Coke, the fuel. Where's our tin at?
Oh, it's over here, I've got it here.
There we go. Just, when you go on eBay and get your tint, try not to get the $4 ones. Please, just spend the extra 10 bucks and get the fucking $14 ones and it'll save your life.
It's still cheap.
It's still cheap. I'm speaking from experience, okay? I went for the $4 ones. Not good. Not good, bro. Not good.
And then you measure your tint up and you cut it so it's easier. So it fits around the light. We're only doing the center bit of the light because it looks hectic. We're going for JDM points right now.
JDM points only, remember that.
Yeah.
Alright guys. We just gotta clean these headlights. Gotta make sure there's no dirt on them to get under the tint. So we'll just wipe them down.
We're using this cleaning vinegar.
Don't use that, that's all we got, alright? Just try to use methylated spirits.
Yeah.
Or anything else. That's all we got and it works. So that's all that matters.
You just gotta clean it.
Yep, get all the water, there was a bit of water marks on them, we've got to get those off, and any dirt, we don't want to be under the tin.
Yeah.
We are pretty stingy, but like, we're not that stingy, we just want to, as best as possible in the backyard.
And then you get some paper towel to dry it off.
Thanks, brother. Right now, looking pretty clean. Who needs Valentis?
Yeah.
Seriously.
OEM MY17 lights. Well.
Put them on any 86. And they'll look as hectic as that.
Wow. We didn't show you guys that one because it was test, so yeah.
Alright, so we want to get the water gun just to prevent any air bubbles and make it easier to put on. So we'll just a couple of sprays here.
Couple sprays
on the tin. And then we'll just put it on and just see how the fitment is.
Yep, just full send. Full fucking send.
Full send. We're not waiting around for anything.
So once you put it down, you want to press it down on a rough estimate of where the light is, all the creases, and then you get a heat gun, but we're stingy, so we got a hair dryer, and you got to heat it up, and heat it up, and you just press it down into the corners, and you cut it, and make that shit sharp, you know?
So yeah, I tried to use my thumb on just a bit of this here, just to prevent any scratches, even though there's a protective layer on top of this tin here, so any scratches on there, you can...
Okay, we switched over to the phone, the camera died.
Yep.
Bit stingy, but...
It is what it is. So any crevices, we just want to use the heat gun for.
Yeah.
At the moment, we're just trying to put it down with my thumb as much as possible. We will use a squeegee, I mean, aka a credit card, but not just yet.
We'll try to link in description of the tin, eBay, please sponsor me for my SEMA build, please eBay. I want to cut around the edges to get it exact. Exacto knife would be good, but we've only got like Stanley knife blades. So you just cut on the crease of the line and you just sort of hold it down and hold it against the line to get a straight cut as you can, but you'll fix it up later, don't worry.
We haven't used the heat gun yet, we just did a rough estimation with our thumb, and then we're gonna just try and cut it out and it'll make it a much quicker process.
Yeah.
Cutting it around and then we'll just put it down the side.
And then cut it again after.
Yes, yeah. And we're trying to, there's a bit of a difference here, so we're just gonna try and cut that there, possibly, to make this crease not happen, because this is looking pretty smooth at the moment. But yeah. We'll just continue doing this and get back to you guys soon. Alright, so we've gone to the stage where we're just trying to cut it out. And you'll see we've done a decent okay job.
Yes.
A lot of these creases here, we'll just try to get them out with heat.
And a lot of them are on this top protective film bit. It just looks like...
See a lot of these white bubbles here, they're all on the top layer. These ones here, though, that we can see, they're going to have to get the heat gun treatment. A lot of these are just simple water bubbles that come out after time. We did indeed end up cutting this here. Try to just push this down a bit, but that looks pretty good for what it is. Yep. And we'll just get back to you guys in a second. Now we'll just try to take the clear top layer protector off, see how this goes.
And then you just clean it up after that, get rid of some bubbles.
We can try and get some of the heat gun on some of this.
Get rid of the water bottles.
Yep, push it down with our fingers. Yep, you can already see it's getting a bit better.
Looks pretty good, if you ask me. Seamer ready. Seamer ready for sure.
All that matters, guys, from a distance, it looks good, trust me.
Exactly. When you turn your lights on, it looks good.
Look, we're at Moe's Bunnings Meats, not fucking Concours de Oligons, alright?
Rydalmere Bunnings Meats, every Friday. Be there or be square. Yeah.
Alright guys, as you can see, we can see the finished product here. Looking pretty good, if you ask me. But we'll see you guys in the next one.
We also did the third brake light. Who needs Valentis? We also decided to quickly do the side markers. You don't want to get too close. No, we won't get too close. Don't worry.
We won't get too close. You don't want to see that close.
Nah, they look pretty good if you ask me. Look,
this was no water and no heat, okay? That's pretty impressive.
They look pretty good. We're not going to show you too close, but because we don't want to...
Any of you guys can do them as long as you use water and heat.
Yeah, mate. Next episode, installing spacers. Thank you for watching.